Hello. Welcome to a new Scatter Tools tutorial. Here's a set of objects that we will use to learn the different type of scatter functions in this plugin. Let's start by drawing a sphere, which will act as the distribution surface. We want to scatter these plants on it. The first method we'll see is, use entire surface. Click on Pick Distribution Object button and then select the sphere. Then press Scatter Objects. The plants are distributed on the surface of the sphere, but they are kind of buried. This is because they have the pivot centered at the object. Luckily, we don't need to change the pivots. We can tell the plugin to use the base of the objects as the anchor point. Let's restore the initial positions first and see it. Now they are placed correctly. Let's see how to use only selected faces on the surface to distribute the objects. In Edit Poly or Edit Mesh mode, you can select the desired faces. SplineDynamics Max stores the selection internally, even if you deselect the object. Now if we turn on the option Use Subobject Selection, the objects are distributed only over the selected faces. Check out the difference with and without this option. Sometimes, you will see some objects are excluded. This is because the plugin always prioritizes collision avoidance. You can uncheck the option Orient to Face / Vertex Normal to keep the initial orientation of the objects. Now let's try reducing the object scale. They now fit better on the surface most of the times, always avoiding collisions. The second scattering method is by faces direction. Let's choose Z up direction. But first I will restore the original transforms and reset the parameters to make sure everything is correct. Now you see the plants are placed automatically on top of the sphere, without using face selection. Let's increase the angle threshold to allow a wider range. We can use a smaller scale too. Let's try with other directions to see the difference. Okay, now we'll see another method to scatter objects on the vertices of a spline or a mesh. I will draw a star shape. We choose use vertices or spline knots. Pick the star. You see the objects are placed on the vertices of the spline. Let's draw a cube to see the same function operating on geometry. Now let's create some rectangles to set specific positions to place the objects. The plugin can get the pivots from a set of distribution objects. They can be any type of 3ds Max object. In order for the plugin to accept multiple distribution objects, you must group them first. We will use for this task the last method, placeIt pivots. And this is the result. Pretty good, isn't it? I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next one.